Welcome to a discussion of the planar tracker in DaVinci Resolve and Fusion Studio. Today I want to use the drone footage I have in front of me and do some modification to the field. I want to attach a texture or paint some patch onto the field. This is part of my longer project of trying to bring a spaceship, a CG spaceship, into this live action footage. If you have been following the whole series, then you can just continue with the previous exercise file. If you are only interested in this part, that's also fine, only interested in the planar tracker, then just download the files from my website, the exercise files, to follow along, and I include the footage and my solutions and everything as always. So this part, the planar tracker itself, is only available in the DaVinci Resolve Studio version or Fusion Studio, but not in the free version. However, for this particular case here, I have also a workaround with the corner tracker. It's a little bit tricky. I will quickly mention it at the end of this tutorial if you are following along the series with the free version. But the focus here is the planar version. Okay, grab the footage to follow along and let's get started. If you have been following along, you have seen from the last tutorial that I have created a small 3D scene with these markers, like to indicate the positions in 3D space and the 3D ground plane. And you may be wondering, why don't I just use this and continue and attach the texture directly in 3D space? I can do this, however, it turns out that this is actually a bit more complicated and even a bit more sensitive to the accuracy of your 3D tracking than if I just do it in 2D. If I do this in 3D, I need an accurate 3D camera, I need to position this ground plane in an accurate way, and I need to then set up a projection which projects exactly into this part. It's all possible, it's not a huge deal, but in this case I will do a painting in 2D, so working completely in 2D is actually the faster way and the easier way for me. To set this up, I will show you the complete workflow, including the painting which I will do in Photoshop. If you are not interested in that part, you can skip ahead to the Fusion part only, or if you are using other software, Photoshop is not the requirement. You could use GIMP or Painter or, you know, whatever graphics software you feel most familiar with. You can use this to create the patch, but I thought I'd show you the full workflow and I included this part in this tutorial as well. So to set this up, let me have a look at the clip. So if I check my drone footage at frame 0, I'm a bit back, and then over the clip towards frame 365, I am zooming in, the drone is moving in, and my ground is coming closer. So I need to have a ground patch here where the spaceship is on frame 0. So I need this position, but I need it on the last frame so that I can work on the most detailed version, or the most enlarged part of this ground. I can quickly get this just from the transformation that we already have here. So my spaceship position, I want my spaceship position, and I'm just I will just create a second version of my animation here. So my spaceship obviously flies out. So now I will just temporarily create another version here, version 2 of my animation of the spaceship, where the spaceship just stays on the ground and stays in place, just to get the rough location. So I will make a second version here, go to frame 0 where it's parked in the beginning, and then remove all from the translation group, and I can also remove the rotation. So now the spaceship should be stationary, and if I go to the end, I see where my spaceship is at the end if it doesn't fly off. So I will use this frame, and I can from Fusion I can quickly render out this frame just to have a reference for the position, and I'll just go here into my render range and just take the last frame only and add a saver node here and just render this out. Saver node also works in DaVinci Resolve, in case you are wondering. So landing site with ship is my name, actually with the frame number maybe. And in Fusion Studio I can make a PNG file, for example, or you could also use an EXR file, which also works in DaVinci Resolve. Actually, before I render it, one more thing. I don't really need the full scene here with the markers and everything. I only need the position of the spaceship, so I make my life easy and just remove the rest. So I just disconnect the background and disable the ground plane and disable those markers, so I only have the ship position but with the accurate camera angle from my previous 3D scene. So I'll just render out this. click on render, let's spit this out, and I'm going now into Photoshop and continue there. If you're not interested in Photoshop, just skip ahead. I'll indicate where I continue in Fusion, and you can just load my solution from the 2D image and continue with it from there. In Photoshop, I have loaded three layers, so let's have a look at them. First of all, the background, then I have loaded the ship and already renamed them, so this is just for reference. And I also loaded a crater, which is a public domain image from NASA. So this crater is actually from Mars, but it shows nicely the outline of the shape, and that's what I'm using here. I will now quickly bring this together and do some combining, compositing, painting. I will do this quickly, also use keyboard shortcuts, because I just want to demonstrate the workflow. I don't want to really start teaching Photoshop in this channel. There are like millions of tutorials out there if you're interested. And if you're not interested, I'll give you the result anyways. So let's just go through this quickly. I'm using the crater not as a colored image because it doesn't match exactly. I'll just use it for creating the shape and shadow of the crater. So the first thing I will do is desaturate it, Control U for this menu, okay, desaturate it. Then I will, actually I don't want like millions of layers here, so I will just rasterize this thing and work destructively in some parts of this, which is fine for this. I know some people don't like this, doesn't matter. Control T to transform, and now let me scale it down. And also to get the first idea, let's bring it under the ship and set it to multiply. So this is how I want to bring this the shadows in, or the dark area, by just multiplying the grayscale image. And I definitely need to squeeze it. I will mask it a little bit. And also the shadow here in the crater is coming, the light here is coming like from the left. We see shadows here. In our scene, it's the exact opposite. So shadows are coming from this direction. Control T, transform, flip horizontal. And now my shadows are coming nicely from the other side. So I'm placing it underneath like this. Let me now look only at this and do some modifications here. First of all, I don't need this underneath. So let me just mask this area out, and I'll just do a content aware fill. Or you could also paint into it or clone into it, but Photoshop has this content aware fill thing here, which I just use the defaults, and something happened. I don't need this to multiply, but normal, and I'll directly merge it in to get rid of the layer. So now I have this filled. I will also get some loose mask around this. Well, let's make a hard mask first and then feather later as per requirements. So I'll just make something very loose first, something like this, and mask this. Now let's look again like together how it looks like, and I can always feather a mask afterwards and make it soft. Now that's definitely too much, like this. And I might go take the paint tool and make this even closer later. Let's see how it looks at the end. Now I have my crater roughly in place. I want to change the texture so I don't see the field through the crater, but instead see more like a ground which is like used, or which, you know, where the spaceship was standing on. So I'm using some textures from other areas. I can use textures from here. So let me go into my ground layer, and I start from here. Let me take out some patch from here, something like this. And I will now place that in, Control J to lift it up into its own layer, and from here V to move the patch around, and now I'm bringing it in here, and I will also scale this a bit in perspective, shift drag in Photoshop, maybe make it a bit smaller, and now I will bring this all around and match this all around. So Control Alt, I should select first, and then Control Alt to move it around. So this way I can patch this all around. Okay, very quickly. Not aiming for perfection here. Okay, what do I have here? I have a layer which looks like this. Now I can definitely randomize this a bit and soften it a bit. Let me use the clone brush for this. Let's take a medium-sized brush and sample some areas. And I am, sorry, deselect. And now I can paint in some areas. Oh, that's a strange brush. This is from maybe another step later. Let me use a soft round brush and undo this. And just, you know, paint in some of these gaps and select from different areas just to randomize things up a bit and get rid of some of these too obvious patches. Although a bit of structure coming from these lines, if they're not exactly straight, might even be desirable. Let's enable this again. This doesn't look so bad. Maybe I want to get even some other ground into this. So if I want, I can do the same principle. And maybe I can use the clone brush. So let me, for example, clone something from this hill here and put a bit, maybe in the darker area here, put a bit, sorry, I need to sample again, sample a few times and, you know, paint some of this structure in. Maybe a bit from here, just have to be careful what I'm selecting. Or perhaps go on to multiply, so I can also use darker ones, reduce the opacity a bit. Too dark, maybe with 20% or so, and multiply some of this part here, just to get things a bit more random and to the way. But I think all in all, the inner part doesn't look so bad. If you want, you can even go further and paint a little bit. So let me use now a paintbrush, B for paintbrush, and I select a brush which looks random, like something like I had by accident before. What do I have here? This one here, or this looks actually a bit, this looks nice. Let's see how it looks like. Let me put it on a separate layer. I tend to mess up as soon as I use brushes in Photoshop, so this I rather want to leave on a separate layer. And let's see how this looks like. Oh, not so bad. Perhaps a bit more, if I go into the dynamics, I can, or here in the, I can do some spacing to this, to space this out a bit, and go into the dynamics. Oh, the jitter is already up. That's fine. So this controls like the randomness of this brush, and randomness is always great to get like natural kind of structures instead of straight lines, which would reveal that it's a painting. Transfer pen pressure. Okay, so some scattering, maybe not too much to. Okay, so this looks nice. Let me delete all this, bring the original layer back on, make it a bit smaller. And now I can sample a bit and, you know, maybe paint in some more dark areas here to make this look like a bit deeper all in all. I'm not exactly sure about the shadows. Maybe I want them a bit more like spread out, or you might want to remove them a bit, dial it down a bit, but I think this might already work. And then here it's a bit flatter, which I think is okay. Maybe we can paint a bit into this. And in the middle, maybe it's a bit ground. Okay. Some cases better, smaller brush strokes and more variation. Maybe follow some of these lines that are already like in the ground. Okay, you can spend quite a lot of time on this, but keep in mind at the end we are looking like from this distance, and then at the beginning there's a spaceship on top. Let's see again how that looks like. So now I definitely need to clean up here all around a bit. So first maybe I select this mask here. This is definitely the maximum where I want to go, and just Control-Shift-I to invert the mask and delete it from the other layer. So I delete whatever I'm painting outside and whatever I copied here outside. So I delete what's outside. And then perhaps I need to go into this and make it a bit softer, either through the controls here with the feather. Let's see, can I get a bit more here? No, that's getting difficult. Just tiny little bit. And then maybe use a paint into the mask here with a black brush. Let me just select a round soft brush for this, and with a round soft and black brush, black in the foreground, I paint directly into the mask. and I can this way change the mask and bring this up a bit, definitely get rid of these hard edges for now. Let's just do this on this, and then I can apply the same to the other. So I don't want these kind of hard areas, something like this. So a bit burned outside of this crater maybe makes sense, or a bit darker, but something that naturally goes over into the other scene. And now maybe I just copy the mask and apply the same mask here and here. Okay, I think that's it for Photoshop. I could probably do a little bit more. Maybe I do a little bit of cleanup on my own before taking it into Fusion, like on the top. But everything is in principle here. So let's go back to the main topic and do the actual tracking back into Fusion. So in Fusion, I have loaded the whole image here with the patch, which I not want to match over the drone footage, and I have included it from Photoshop with the background so that I can have the reference as well and can see if the colors and everything still matched and everything works fine in my workflow. And I can of course easily mask this out. I just add an ellipse here on top, put it on the patch, and I can mask out the patch to whatever size I need it to. So let me take this with a little bit of background and merge it over. And if everything went well in my workflow, then on the last frame I should have a perfect match. Do I have that? Yes, looks like it. So on the last frame you don't see any boundaries, nothing. It matches perfectly. Now I need the motion towards the first frame so that I can have it stick to the ground, and let me bring in the planar tracker for this. Control spacebar planar tracker, here I have it, and let me attach it to my original drone footage. And here I now have to select the surface which I want to track throughout the timeline, and in theory you could just try to, you know, track this little patch. This is the area where we actually need it. But the problem is, if I look at the footage here, that I have hardly any contrast here. However, I need the transformation of the plane, so I can select any area on this plane which is around this patch and which relates to this patch. So rather than taking something small here without contrast, I can try to get the largest possible patch which reflects this planar movement or this transformation I'm looking for. If you wanted to take the whole ground here, in principle you could, but then you would need to exclude the wind turbines, which you can with the exclusion mask here, so you would have to mask them out. I make it simpler, I just take the largest area which doesn't interfere with these turbines, because they have the perspective shift, so I just need the ground itself. So that being said, let me, on the last frame, let me grab the largest area I can possibly get here. So something like this, I go up till here. I won't take the horizon because it's very far away and it will be difficult to get the perspective up till the very last point, and not necessary, but I definitely want these changes here in the fields and like these corners and this kind of patch here, and maybe a little bit like from the ground of the wind turbine here without having the actual transformation here, even the shadow here. I take this patch, and then here I have to stay a bit clear because this is moving in, so I have to stay clear of the wind turbine itself, but I think I can go till here and then to the ground, and I take this here. We have some nice contrasty items on the ground which I can hopefully also capture. So this is my selection, and this is the area which I'm now trying to track. So operation mode track is right. I am on the last frame, which I set as my reference frame, because this is to where I need to match my patch here. On the pattern, nothing to do, so I just selected the pattern. And the tracker hybrid point area is the more accurate one, so point just tries to take points, and here like whole surface is compared from one frame to the next. Perspective is right. In some cases, if you have very easy like left-right movement or something like this, you can restrict it here. But in this case, the full drone flight, I need to solve for the whole perspective. Output, I don't care. We will see later. Track channel, again, if you wanted to, you could restrict to the blue channel or to green or so. I stick to the Luma channel here. It's the same principle that you had in the 3D camera track. Let's give it a try with the Luma, maybe that already works. And I am on the last frame, need to track back all the way to the first frame, which is this symbol here, track to start, and let it run. This might take a minute or two or three or four, depending on your computer, but for me it's around 1 minute. I save you even that minute and skip forward. Here I have it. Let me make it a bit larger and review how it looks like. This is how it plays. Now I do have a little bit of, tiny little bit of jitter here in the lower corner. I guess here the contrast was just not enough, but we'll see if that has really any impact for the patch here. I think we might get away with this. So for now, let me keep this and I click now here on Create Planar Transform. So this adds a tool in my flow. Where is it? I'd added it here at the beginning. I extract it, and this planar transform I can now use to apply the same transformation that Fusion just calculated for this mask. The same transformation I can apply now to any other object, any other image. So I want to apply it to my patch. So just after this landing site, I just paste this planar transform that I just got. Okay, maybe I make it a bit larger here. So here I have the planar transform, no settings basically. And with this, if I bring now the patch in, I can check. You see here the gray circle around, so the color doesn't match on frame zero, so or the brightness, so we have to tweak this a little bit. But I'm looking at the movement, and the movement relative to the field here seems to be very stable. So I don't see any sliding or jittering or anything like this. So this seems to be accurate, which is great. Now let's have a look at the brightness. So at the end it matches, and then somewhere here you see that outside it's the brightness doesn't match exactly. So let me just bring in a brightness and contrast after my patch here, and with a slight animation I can hopefully take care of it. So at the end it's fine. So let's try just a simple gamma correction. At the end I keyframe it at the default, and at the beginning I see that it's a bit too dark here and also too dark here. So if I just bring the gamma a little bit up, here it's getting too bright, but this is pretty close. So now with an animation like this, I should, it's hardly noticeable, the boundary. And for the rest of it, I will just soften the edge of this ellipse a little bit. So I just give this a slight soft edge. Let's have a look at the ellipse. So this is all as part of the boundary of this patch. Okay, maybe too much. It gets transparent in between, a bit less. But this should be enough to hide any issues from the boundary where it's not where the luminance is not matching exactly throughout the whole scene, or not matching left and right. So this way, I think it now fits pretty well. Okay, let me have a look at the full sequence. So this is now how it looks like. This looks like a good patch where I can place my spaceship on top. I can now remove the planar tracker here. I don't really need it anymore, but maybe I leave it in the flow for reference if you want to look at it, if you have a look at the download files. Finally, let me show you a small trick you can do if you do not have the planar tracker available, like if you were working in the free version of DaVinci Resolve or in the free version of Fusion 9, or if you have very good corner points that you can track, but have trouble with the planar tracking tool, then you can still use the normal simple tracking tool. You can use a corner positioner to place this patch. And let me just, I have quickly set it up here, and let me just show you what I mean. So I have on my last frame here, I have just tracked 4 points, which are very obvious and easy to track, like the point here on the bottom of these wind turbines. They are very stable and very high contrast, and I have taken this point as well. So this way I have 4 points. There is a corner positioning option somewhere here in the tracker operation. Corner positioning or perspective, these are like the opposite of each other. So corner positioning is usually used to take like a rectangular image and place it into like a perspective corner. So this was like the traditional way how you would replace a TV screen, for example. You take the corners of the screen, assuming you can track those, and then you can have a flat image and position it into those 4 corners. Here, of course, we don't really want to position something into those 4 corners. And also, we already have this image in perspective, so we have to apply some tricks. And the trick I'm doing is I'm not using the tool here, but I'm using the perspective positioner and the corner positioner together as separate tools. So the corner positioner outside does the same as inside, but the only difference is you can also, it works beyond the boundaries of this corner. So you can have objects which are outside. So this still works. And the perspective positioner does the opposite of the corner positioner. So let's take it backwards. So in the corner positioner, each corner here I have linked to the tracking points. So here you see the tracker 1 for top left, tracker 2 top right. So, you know, just if you want to do this, just right click connect to, which I already have done. So if I remove it, connect to tracker 1, path 1, position. So I'm just connecting these 4 points to the 4 tracker points. This way I have the corner positioner set up to project into this rectangle. And then before this corner positioner, I have the perspective positioner where I have just copied the value from the last frame. So the last frame is where I have my patch here in correct perspective. With the perspective positioner, it takes it out of perspective based on these 4 points. And I don't have clipping here in these tools, so I'm even projecting it kind of out of the frame. But it's kind of flattening it. So from the perspective, I'm flattening it into a straight picture on the last frame with the positioning points of this corner positioner. And then the corner positioner brings it exactly back into the place where it was, even though this place is outside the 4 corners. And then with the corner positioner being linked to the tracker, the corner positioner changes the perspective based on these 4 points. And thereby I can ultimately get this patch placed onto the ground, and I get a stable perspective correction based on 4 points on the plane here, even though those 4 points do not directly relate to this patch. Okay, there we have it. A second option to get the same effect without the need for the planar tracker and without the need for the studio version. So sometimes maybe even with the planar tracker, maybe you find places where you just have these 4 points and you can easily set this up. However, I must warn you, I feel it's more like a workaround, because if these corners are not good, you won't get anywhere. If it's very pointy, or the kind of transformation that happens here between the perspective and the corner positioner, if it gets like completely distorted or gets completely transformed far away, this may become unstable. I have had some crashes with this as well. So I consider this more like a workaround, and I might go to the planar tracker first. All right, so with this patch, I have my landing or takeoff site of my spaceship prepared for those of you who follow the whole tutorial series. So last week I did the animation and we got a shadow, even though just in the 3D scenario. But now I think it's time to throw everything together, composite the shadow in, bring the spaceship in, bring everything on top of this prepared backplate. And this will be the task for next week. I'm really looking forward to this. If you do have any questions up to this point, just let me know in the comments. And otherwise, as always, a click on like is highly appreciated. And looking forward to next week. See you then. Thanks for watching.